Wendell Berry wrote, "The earth is what we all have in common." Sending blessings to the Cosm Love Tribe, coming together under the light of the full moon all over our blue planet. It's an extraordinary feat of human technology to be able to connect with you through the World Wide Web. Where are you watching from today? Put your location in the chat. We are broadcasting from a 40-acre woodland site next to the Hudson River on the traditional lands of the Wappingers people in the Hudson Valley of New York State. I help facilitate the visionary permaculture program here at Cosm with my dear wife, Grace. Permaculture supports people to grow gardens and also to cultivate consciousness, bringing a holistic perspective on the place of people in the evolutionary history of life on Earth. Tonight, I will share a visualization, my version of science's creation story derived from the archaeological record, which I first learned from my eco-heroes, John Seed and Joanna Macy. Together, we can contemplate our more than human world from a more than human perspective. The intention is to inspire imagination, explore evolution, and support a legacy of planetary stewardship. Cradled in the 12.8 billion year history of the Milky Way galaxy, our solar system arrived from a free horizon of cosmic clouds and galactic gases. 4.5 billion years ago, our planet was formed by the force of solar winds and gravity coalescing interstellar matter, then followed by a 500 million year period when the Earth began to cool. 3.8 billion years ago, the world ocean of prebiotic soup was potentized by an unknown event and the miraculous first cell was born. We all trace our genetic and epigenetic lineage to this single event, as does every cell of every living thing on Earth. Every single cell in our bodies is a direct descendant in an unbroken chain from that original cell. In this way, we are energetically and physically related to all living things. The first one-celled organisms evolved into forms of photosynthesizing bacteria, creating oxygen that formed the Earth's biosphere. For over 2 billion years, life on Earth was entirely microbes who survived 2 10-million-year ice ages. These single-celled organisms branched into the ancestors of plants, fungi, and animals 1.5 billion years ago. The first multicellular organisms emerged and evolved into algae 300 million years later, creating an atmosphere that killed much of the bacteria and made it possible for further developments of life. Over the following period, there were 3 more ice ages when a snowball Earth wiped out many prehistoric gene pools. 580 million years ago, simple water creatures like flatworms, jellyfish, and sponges began to inhabit the world ocean. 30 million years later came the fungi, creating a new branch of being. Fish came 50 million years later, the first vertebrates to emerge from the evolutionary chain of being. 40 million years later, fungi and green plants moved onto the land, creating the conditions for even more diversity of life. Millipedes and centipedes were amongst the first animals to travel across the land 400 million years ago. Spiders and scorpions developed soon after, and early wingless insects like silverfish could be seen amongst the prehistoric plants. 330 million years ago, the Earth's geography began to develop as a supercontinent known as Pangaea, beginning a period of unbridled evolution. Insects developed wings, and 2-foot-long dragonflies could be seen flying through forests of ferns, moss, and horsetail. During this time, seed-bearing plants swept across the fertile lands, and the amphibians began to emerge. 30 million years later came reptiles, some of whom evolved into the great dinosaurs over a 70 million year period. It was an age of monsters and mayhem in a vast civilization of wild animals. 175 million years ago, Pangaea began to split apart and the continents formed. These were populated with dinosaurs and increasingly forested landscapes. 45 million years later, pollen-containing flowers began to form and beautiful new colors came to our gardenic Earth. During this chapter, the first proto-mammals developed. 65 million years later, a huge meteor struck the Earth in an extinction-level event, killing most of the dinosaurs and making space for mammalian development. 10 million years later, the first primates began to appear, changing into our early ancestors over a 40 million year evolutionary process. Major climatological changes on the planet saw the great rainforests recede and turn to grasslands. Tribal ape cultures began to develop. It was only a mere 430,000 years ago that the Neanderthal began the evolutionary ascent into modern humanity. The earliest cave paintings show humans communicating with art 35,000 years ago, marking the beginning of recorded human history. This evolutionary storyline shows that our roots reach deep. To this day, the first few weeks of human embryonic development is identical to the embryonic development of all animals, reptiles, and fish. We are all connected. I'm amazed to be surfing the new edge of the evolution with all of you. Grateful to be working together as a conscious community to co-create a better world. Special thanks to those of you who have signed up as members of COSM. Together, we are a force of light and good in the world. Jane Goodall said, "What you do makes a difference, and you have to decide what kind of a difference you want to make." Happy full moon, everyone.